German prosecutors today ask for life imprisonment for a right-wing extremist charged with killing two people last year outside a synagogue in Germany's east. That comes as calls grow to investigate the extent of neo-Nazi infiltration of the country's security services. 1,400 cases of far-right extremism among soldiers, police officers, and intelligence agents have been documented over the past 3 years, a frightening echo of Germany's past. From Berlin, special correspondent Malcolm Brabant reports.
Back to the future in a bleak East Berlin suburb. Right-wingers marked 30 years of German reunification with a rally ripe with 1930s attitudes. Up went a chant from a banned neo-Nazi song predicting ultimate victory. This group has sprung from an outlawed extremist party, the Third Path, that shares ideology with similar European groups. Its logo contains a nod to Hitler's Third Reich.
The last 3 to 4 years have clearly shown that multiculturalism has failed, and it's our job to end it. We have to rely on our own people for our future, for the safety of our children and grandchildren.
The command, advance on Berlin. Alarm bells are ringing about the far-right surge. These protesters wanted to confront the neo-Nazis. The police kept them apart as an anti-fascist anthem played. Militaristic displays are outlawed in Germany. The police ordered them not to march, but to, quote, saunter casually. The instruction was ignored.
These people are some of the most extreme neo-Nazis in Germany, and there are many groups like this. But what the authorities are worried about is not these people so much who are out in public, it's those neo-Nazis who are hiding in the establishment in the shadows.
This video by the Bundeswehr, the German military, eulogizes the prowess of an elite special forces unit called the KSK. But today it's in disgrace. One company has been disbanded because of a right-wing extremist culture. A cache of weapons, ammunition and explosives was found buried at the home of one soldier.
If you're looking for a special unit who could take over the German chancellery or the most important ministries within Berlin, then this was the most important unit to do so.
Timo Reinfrank's mission is to counter right-wing violence. He heads a foundation named after Amadeo Antonio, an Angolan immigrant murdered by extremists in 1990. Reinfrank worries that neo-Nazis have infiltrated other branches of the German military.
The problem about the army is that we don't know anything. This is a more or less closed shop that we only hear in the public from special incidents. But we know that the majority of the right-wing scene is full of trained people from the German Bundeswehr.
These concerns are shared by Germany's highest echelons. Last month's celebrations, muted by COVID-19, were supposed to toast the 30-year-long marriage of East and West Germany after the Iron Curtain disintegrated. But President Frank-Walter Steinmeier was compelled to call for vigilance against neo-Nazis.
They want another state, an authoritative state that aggressively excludes parts of society. They see themselves as part of a tradition that this republic doesn't stand for and that has nothing to do with our democracy.
Hours after that speech, outside Hamburg's synagogue, a man in military fatigues attacked a Jewish student with a shovel, inflicting grave head injuries. Germany's anti-Semitism czar, Felix Klein.
Nobody can deny the deadly dimension of anti-Semitism and right-wing extremism in Germany anymore. Right-wing extremism is a big threat of democracy in Germany.
The German police are not immune either. Confidence in the police was rocked after 30 officers were suspended for sharing extreme material in online chat groups that included images of Adolf Hitler and depictions of a refugee in a gas chamber. Hacker Kleffner leads a non-profit that supports victims of right-wing violence. She is one of hundreds of people named on right-wing death lists.
We have police officers who supply right-wing terror networks with information from police database on political enemies. And we have police officers who spread anti-Semitic and National Socialist propaganda.
Ferhat Koçak, a left-wing politician with Turkish heritage, almost lost his life because of police collusion or negligence. A police inquiry admitted that officers knew neo-Nazis were planning an arson attack on Koçak, but failed to inform him.
The fire spread to the house, and it was luck that we survived with my family. I get a lot of messages with death threats. And I'm not the only one, so a lot of friends also get these death threats, but they always say it is, we wait for the right time to kill you.
The government insists that 99% of police officers are anchored in the law and only a minority are rotten, a view echoed by Berlin police spokesman Thilo Kaulblitz.
For us as Polizistinnen und Polizisten,
for us as police officers, it hurts. It hurts because we join this profession with a certain idealism and we stand firmly on the ground of our liberal democratic constitution. And if there are people within our ranks who call themselves police officers but who do not share our common understanding and our oath, then it hurts us no end.
Despite official admissions of culpability from both military and the police, activists believe there is not enough transparency.
We have a lot of Nazis in authorities, and it is important to start to change this now.
One thing that absolutely needs to happen is an independent scientific research on the percentage of hardcore racists and anti-Semites within the German police force.
Germany's main concern is the neo-Nazis' ambition to launch a violent uprising one day in the future.
This situation is precisely our chance to excite people again for a real alternative, to completely change the system so that the German people can once again live in a country worth living in.
Although he doesn't believe the Third Reich could be resurrected, President Steinmeier warned against complacency.
The colors of this democratic history are the colors black, red, and gold, the colors of unity, justice, and freedom. We will not allow them to be driven away, misused, or appropriated.
The anniversary celebrations culminated at the Brandenburg Gate that once marked the division between East and West. Beneath its neo-Nazi cloud, Germany is a long way from being truly united. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Malcolm Brabant in Berlin.